Hey, Pulse Youth Group, this is David, your youth pastor. It is December 7th, 2011, and these are your Wednesday night announcements. I'm sitting in the best office in the world with all my iMacs and all this fun stuff. No, that's not true. I'm in Pastor Jared Fox's office, and why haven't you guys turned in your registration forms for winter camp yet? You got to get on that stuff. Come on, we're going with Christ Church. It's going to be amazing. Get on it and pay attention to the rest of these announcements.
You are a teenager, which means you have a lot going on. Think about your life and the activities that take up your time and energy. School, work, sports, clubs. Think about your relationships. Think about your hobbies and your passions. Think about what you do to have fun. It's quite a list, isn't it? You have so many things in your life that compete for your attention. In fact, you may have so much going on that if you're honest, it's hard to give any one thing your attention at all. Your time, energy, and passions are divided among so many things. But what if deep down inside, all of this running around, chasing the stuff that surrounds you, what if it's pulling you away from something, or better yet, someone that should be at the heart of who you are? What if the things you think about and do are actually distractions from the one who deserves all of your devotion? What if what you need more than anything else in life is to reevaluate your focus? Ask yourself these questions. What is at the center of who you are? Who is at the center of who you are? Is it you? Is it the things you do and the stuff that you love? Or is it a Savior? Is it Christ? Jesus is second to no one. He is the focus of creation, the central figure of history. But the real question is he the center of your life? Is Christ your focus?
First thing Jesus says to his disciples is, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men. Last thing he says is, go and make these disciples, these people who follow me. And in between those two statements, he spent a lifetime of showing them what it means to follow God, showing them what it means to make disciples or to fish for men. Then he goes, now go and do the same thing. Where it gets weird is that nowadays, there are millions of people on this earth who call themselves followers of Jesus, but their lives look nothing like his. And yet in their hearts they're convinced they're followers.
Eve, where are you going to be? Well, the place to be is at my house. So come to 17342 East Caliente Drive, 7 o'clock on New Year's Eve, and we're going to party until it's next year. Be there or just be somewhere else.
Yeah, tap like a spaceship. It's shocking, ain't it? Might wanna take this. It's gonna make your face live like a space shield. Don't you see it all? I don't gonna hate this. It's gonna make your face live like a space shield. It's shocking, ain't it? Might wanna take this. It's gonna make your face live like a space shield.
I give up, let me talk about me, man.
I don't gonna hate this.
Let me tell you.
live like a space jail. It's shocking, ain't it? Might wanna take this. It's gonna make your face live like a space jail. Don't you seen it all? I think I'm gonna hate this. Yeah. It's gonna make your face live like a space jail. Yeah.
Bet you think you fresh. Bet you think you next. Just cause you cash us some checks. Probably think you be in depth to that Ruger 45. Bow! Blow off half your neck. It's only one God. He is incorruptible. Nothing like us. He got all power and indestructible.